It's not my intention to become a smart home channel, but here I am sharing another ESPHome project. This time I've been learning how to print values from Home Assistant to this 16x2 text LCD. There are many ways to do that, and I'm showing you the way that is quite versatile and gives you freedom to configure the output as you wish. I'm using the PCB I got from the sponsor of this video, PCBWAY.com. They offer a PCB starting from just $5 plus shipping for 10 pieces of 100x100mm boards. You can also get your CNC machined or 3D printed parts from them. And if your project needs, for example, this kind of LCD module, they have some in the module store section. For all your prototyping needs, go check out PCBWAY.com for current offering and pricing. Nowadays, hobbyists can get all kinds of displays, OLED, e-paper, graphical LCD. While all those displays have their own advantages and they are cool, I often find myself using the classic HD44780-based text LCD module. These come in many different sizes. Some very common sizes are 20x4, 20x2, and this 16x2. These are so old school, any microcontroller with a couple of GPIO pins can drive these. For modern microcontrollers with I2C interface, this type of display with I2C adapter on the back makes wiring even simpler, requiring just 4 wires: power, SCL, SDA, and ground. This is how I have connected the display to VMOS D1 mini port, and I'm taking a risk by using a 5V LCD with 3.3V VMOS D1 mini. The I2C interface port on the back of the LCD module has 4.7 kΩ pull-up resistors pulling SCL and SDA to 5V, while that 5V connected to GPIO pin through 4.7 kΩ resistor doesn't immediately destroy the part, it's not recommended. It is recommended to use 3.3V display module powered from 3.3V, or use I2C voltage level translator between LCD and ESP8266 port. The ESPHome configuration has the usual default things in the beginning, including port setup and also API and Wi-Fi sections. The part written for this project includes I2C component, where I have defined SDA and SCL pins, and also enabled scanning. The scanning is useful at the beginning. It shows found I2C device addresses in the log. These display modules usually have address 0x27, but if it was something else, I could have seen it in the log after restarting the board. I decided to handle forming the text for each line in the Home Assistant's automations, which is why I have 2 text sensor components in ESPHome configuration, with platform Home Assistant and entity IDs input text LCD1 and input text LCD2. I will show in a second how I came up with these entity IDs, which are used to link these text sensor components to text fields in the Home Assistant. But before that, there's one more component in this configuration, that is the display with platform LCD_PCF8574, indicating the IC used in the I2C interface port of the LCD module. Dimensions field is set to match the width and height of the display, and address is 0x27, the usual address for these modules. This lambda section prints value from text sensor component with ID line 1 on the first line of the LCD and line 2 on the second line. Whenever those values change, the display will automatically be updated. Now I'll show where I got the entity ID values for the text sensor components. In Home Assistant, I went to Settings, Devices and Services, Helpers. There I clicked the Create Helper, selected text type, gave it a name and also set the maximum length to match the width of the display, 16. After creating the helper, I was able to check the entity IDs in this list of helpers. I created own helper for both lines of the text. At this point, I was able to test if this works. Clicking the helper on the list opened a pop-up where I wrote a new value for it and hit enter, and that text was printed on the display. It may be handy to be able to manually send something to the display, but I needed a way to show the sensor data in the display. As demonstration, I'm showing the brightness of one of my smart lights. In Settings, Automations and Scenes, I created a new automation. I set the trigger to be Entity State. I specified the entity, in this case it's one of my lights, and to trigger on the brightness change, I also specified the attribute to be brightness. Now this automation runs every time that light's brightness changes, and the action is something like this. This sets the value of the input text LCD2, which is the entity ID of the text helper created previously. The value or the text starts with written word brightness followed by raw brightness value in range from 0 to 255 divided by 255 and multiplied by 100 to get the value in percent. It's important to round the number, in this case to 0 decimal points, to make it fit in the limited space on the LCD. I also added another action to this automation, which prints the friendly name of that same light on the first line of the LCD. Now when I change the brightness, the value on the LCD changes. This was just a demonstration with variables that I can easily change. More practical application would be to show temperature from a sensor or something similar. I hope at least some of you found this useful. See you next video. Thanks, bye.